Oh my gracious geese. It is 1:15 a.m. I just got home from the opening night of the Evolve Tour. It was so good! It was so good!
Hey, I'm Annie, and this is Why You Should Love Music.
Okay, a lot of you guys have been asking me to do concert vlogs for a long time, and I was like, no, I suck at vlogging. The fact that I suck at vlogging has not changed, but I decided I'd make this for you guys because the very first show of the Evolve Tour happened to be the one I was going to. I was like, so I thought it was a good opportunity to, try out the concert vlog thing. I still don't understand how to do it. We are driving to Phoenix and listening to old school classics on the radio, and you guys get to meet my father. He's very excited. He's bad at the clarinet, I think. He was literally just singing California Dreamin' right before I started recording. Anyway, that's the story, that's the update. Going to Phoenix.
First things first, I'ma see all the words inside my head. I'm fired up and tired of the way that things have been. Oh, ooh, the way that things have been. Oh, ooh.
Let's talk about it. I just got home. Let's decompress. Let's process this together. Okay. Kay Flay was the first opener. I'm a really big fan of hers. She's an amazing writer and an excellent poet. She has a lot of swearing in her music, so it's not something that I listen to a lot. But her song Dreamers absolutely blows me out of the water. I'm obsessed with that song, and she played it tonight, and that was like the one song I was like, I really hope she played it. And I have to say, when she first came out, I was shocked and blown away at the texture of her voice. I wasn't sure how she would transition to a stadium venue. I didn't know how she would do. She's amazing. Her voice was made to be heard in stadiums. It was epic. Her guitarist, I will not lie to you, he was a mess. It was super muddy, and half the time I was like, can the music stop and just let me hear her sing? Because she was doing an amazing job. To be in all fairness to the guitar player, I could not tell if it was his fault or if it was the sound guy or what, because it's hard when you go into a venue cold. Obviously they had practices and whatnot, but it's always an adjustment period. But it didn't get better throughout the set. It was really... I feel like the guitar got worse throughout it, but her drummer was pretty good, and she was fantastic. It was so fun to watch her. She's stylistically right up my alley. It was fantastic, but I was just shocked at the texture of her voice. It sounds exactly like it does from the studio, but it was live, and I was like, how are you doing that? She's just that talented. That's her real voice. It was insane. Couldn't believe it. Then Grouplove went. I am a huge fan of Grouplove. I was hugely disappointed in their set. I knew that they were gonna have a lot of, they always have amazing, incredible energy live, and they really like went gung-ho, full force. And the guitar was a lot better. The sound, I don't know if it's the sound guy or the guitarist or what, they had obviously different guitarists, but the guitars were a lot better, but the mics had, the vocals had really bad pitch issues. Like, it was really painful. I think it's because they couldn't hear, because I know that they're absolutely incredible musicians. I think it was a monitor issue in their earpieces, but it was actually quite painful a lot of the set. But that being said, it was still fun to watch them. Hannah and Christian are just adorable and just full of life and energy. My favorite part of their set was probably Christian did a cartwheel, which was absolutely fantastic. It was very fun. But their set in general was a pretty big letdown. I was thinking about it while I was there, and I was kind of, but I was kind of imagining, like, this feels like, I feel in a lot of ways their music really lends itself to a festival setting more than a stadium, so I don't know if that threw them off or what, but I feel like hopefully they'll kind of get warmed up as they go on as they go do more shows on the tour, hopefully that will get better. I don't know. Imagine Dragons, I have to say, made everyone else look bad because they just killed every single second, every note, every moment, every line, everything was so good. The production was amazing. The lights were amazing. Oh, that's another thing on Grouplove. Their lights hurt. To be perfectly fair, I have seizure disorder and I was really struggling through Grouplove's set because I know when I'm going to a concert, there's going to be loud music and flashing lights, but it was really, really bad. It was very... I didn't feel like it was artistic. I just felt like it was like, don't have a seizure. But also that's my personal bias, probably, because I was having some health issues. But Imagine Dragons, the light and the set and the stage and everything was so good. We were driving home and I was asking some of the people that I went with. I was like, what was your favorite moment? Like, if you could pick one or two moments, and we're all just kind of like, every moment. So Imagine Dragons had a lot of like voiceover narration to a lot of their songs, particularly the songs from the new album, which doesn't always play well, but this one I felt like really did. It was really interesting and exciting. It kind of just like filled the room with electricity. From before the very first song even began, everyone was just like so amped up and screaming, and you could just feel it in the air. It was insane. It was so good.
This is how it might have looked. How can something come from nothing?
with its time, which is not something that I knew I needed, but it was just like, it just got you right in the feel straight out of the gate. I was like, why it was killing me with that? And they killed it. And then the second song was Gold. They just start, and everyone's like, And then they did the third track, I don't remember, was something from the third album. I love that they started the first album, second album, third album. And I was really surprised. Even though it was the Evolve tour, they had a lot of really significant moments from each album, which I was super excited because as a fan, I love all of their records so completely, but so differently. And there were a lot of insanely powerful moments from each record. Okay, I was the most excited to hear Yesterday live because that track is so insane and I knew that how they were gonna have to really totally reinvent it to do it live, and I was just so pumped for that moment. The second the first chord started, I literally screamed and everyone around me was kind of like, is that woman okay? But then they got into it and they realized what was happening and everyone was screaming and it was insane, it was so good. When it started out, he was like trying to get us to say Yesterday and he was like, Phoenix, just shout it, you don't even have to sing, it's fine. Just scream really loud. It's just one word. And he kept making us do it over and over until it was like insane and it got us really pumped up and it was so excited.
I think you can do better than that. It's only one word. Yesterday. A place of beauty. A place of mistakes. A place of no regret. Of learning, a place of love, a place of pain. Here's to my future, here's to my
yesterday,
here's to change, here's to my
yesterday,
there's no tomorrow.
There was like a little boy in the front and Dan was like watching him during the thing and he told like a cute story after the fact about the little boy.
He was old. He was singing that like he had lived a lifetime. Just like so many like mistakes. He's just like, yesterday! Amazing. You never know. 8 years. A lot can happen. True story, actually. My first memory, this is so embarrassing, but I'm going to share with you. And I remember because yesterday I was talking with my friend, and they were saying, you know those people who promise, they're like, you know, everybody knows like one person who's like, I remember when I was in the womb. They're like, no, my first memory was in the womb. It was dark. There was a heartbeat. Actually, and I'm just like, no, my first memory was when I was 8 years old. True story. I was 8 years old, but my first memory was being 8 years old and thinking, oh my gosh, I'm 8 years old. Everybody thinks that I'm so young, but I know exactly what's going on right now. I'm just going to play up how cute I am. I remember that thought. True story. That's my first memory. I don't remember being 7 or 6 or 5. It was just 8. Don't be like me.
Oh, so good. And then, okay, so they had all this insane, amazing stuff going on. And then halfway through, they started walking to the back of the stadium. And they had like a little tiny stage set up. And they did like some acoustic stuff. Okay, so they had acoustic guitars. But then Wayne plays the cello. Apparently, I just found out. Drummer Dan was playing the viola. It was so funny. Dan Reynolds was like, he was like listing everything that Dan can do, and he was like, man, what don't you do? And he was like, I can't cook. And he was like, what? And he's like, I can't cook. And he's like, what? And he's like, I don't do cooking. It was hilarious. He had to be there. Okay, so the acoustic set, what even? There was a moment with Wayne on guitar. He was doing totally different stuff than what was on the record, obviously, because it's an acoustic set. But it was so good. At that point, my dad just, he leaned forward and he looked at me, and I leaned forward and I looked at him in the exact same moment, and we're like, who is this man? Like, what? It was insanely powerful. And then they let us pick part of the set. Dan was like, do you want this one or this one? And everybody wanted him to do Bleeding Out. So he did. But then afterwards he was like, but we really wanted to do the other one. So he played a little part of it. And I was almost really sad. It was between Dreams and Bleeding Out. And when he said that, I was like, oh, Bleeding Out's going to be amazing, like, in this setting. And he did it, and it was amazing. But then when he started doing Dreams, I was like, he should have done that. It was even better. So if you go to a show, scream louder for Dream. If he offers you that same choice, you want Dreams. The arrangement that he was going to do will blow your mind. It's insane. Then, I really wish I got this on film, but I didn't because I was too in the moment, and also maybe my phone died by this point. Went right before he played I Bet My Life, which was a surprising moment. I didn't expect that to be a really impactful moment. But he made this speech about how the world is so divided right now, but about how music brings us together. But anything I say will sound cheesy and dumb and corny, but it was so powerful in the moment. And there's a room full of thousands, this stadium of thousands of people, and you were all there just like so in the moment and connected and screaming and singing together. And Dan was just saying, color doesn't matter. Politics doesn't matter. I see you, you see me, and that's all that matters. It was such an amazing moment. Another incredible moment. There was one of the voiceovers was the I Have a Dream Martin Luther King speech, mixed with this like science thing about a caterpillar becoming a butterfly, which sounds stupid when I say it, but it was insane in the moment. So good. Okay, when they played Radioactive, I about lost it. I did lose it, but my sister leaned over to me and she was like, what about our other sister? Why is she not here? And I was like, I know, but we were just singing and screaming and it was insane. And then, oh, there's too many moments. I can't say everything. It was insane. There was confetti. There was beach balls. Smoke shooting up out the stage. Mostly just like I lost my mind anytime Wayne did literally anything. Of course, you have the drums that they always do. That was so good. So then they left, and of course, nobody stopped screaming. So when they came back to the encore, they did Believer. I was so surprised. The first thing that you notice is the setup from the Believer. They had like the prisms from the Believer music video, and then they also had the crystals from the Thunder music video. But they had already done Thunder, but they never did Believer. So they came back for the encore, and they did Believer, and it was insane. And then they also did, after that, they did Walking the Wire, which I was surprised for a last song, but it totally worked. I already liked that song, but it sold me on it even more. Every track that they did that I hadn't seen live, I was like, I understand it so much better now. I love it so much better now. Just to feel the energy. At one point, Dan was literally like laying on the ground. Like, I know a lot of rock stars do like the, you know, they do this thing where they're like, na-na-na. No, Dan was just like, la, 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 la. It was insane. It was so good. And he did a lot of like throwing it and like screaming. Oh, it was so powerful. And he was so like genuine and sincere. And he had like these amazing, honest moments where he was just talking to us. It was such a powerful moment too, because he was telling us, you know, this tour starts here. We're going to take this energy and take it around the world. And it was such an amazing experience. Musically, technically, it was so good. But also it was just so like emotionally uplifting and connecting. It was insane. It was so good. You guys, I hope that you're all able to go see Imagine Dragons live at some point. If not on this tour, I hope that they come to where you are sometime and you can see it. And if you do go to their tour, I hope you have the greatest time ever. I know Dan has mentioned they're gonna change up the set list probably night to night. I feel like they are over prepared so that they can do like last minute switch ups, but it's so good. Everything was incredible. And if you do go to this tour, I wish you luck on the Grouplove set. Hopefully, I love Grouplove. They're such great musicians. They're such great writers. I have every faith in them. It was just an off night, so hopefully that's better. And I love Kay Flay. I know she's amazing, but I was still shocked at how perfectly textured her voice was. Not perfect, like annoyingly flawless, but just like how deeply rich and textured it was. And I was like, this woman was born to rock a stadium. Like, yes, do this for the rest of your life. She's incredible right now. I can't even imagine where she's gonna be in a couple years. Oh, so good. It was so good. I hope you guys are having a fantastic time. I'm gonna go put on some Imagine Dragons record and sift through some photos and video. I love you all. That was my first concert vlog. Sorry, it probably sucked and was boring and had no purpose. I'm just really stoked about this. And yeah, it's gonna be a great tour, you guys. It was insane. I can't even express. I feel like I'm forgetting. I'm leaving out way too many things because every moment was so, it was really good. I'm not gonna sleep tonight, but I'm gonna go look at some photos and listen to music. I love y'all. Talk to you later. Whatever it takes.